Patients come into the office with a great toe that isn't as mobile as it should be. In some cases, the motion is limited. In other cases, it's rigid. In both cases, they're painful, and after taking an x-ray, there's usually a bone spur on top of the great toe joint. My name is Dr. Andrew Schneider, and I'm a podiatrist in Houston, Texas. In today's video, I'm going to discuss issues involving the great toe joint due to a bone spur that can form on top of the joint. But before I do, please let others know about these videos. Please like, comment, hit the subscribe button, and share on social media. This will help others find this information. I also wrote a book all about bone spurs in the feet. You can get it for free at www.bonespurbook.com. When most people think of a bunion, they think of a prominent bump on the side of the great toe joint. It makes the foot wider and can be painful with shoes. I recorded a video series all about bunions such as these. The link is in the description below. What about a bunion on top of the great toe joint? The bunion on top of the joint, it's a bit different. It can also be because of faulty mechanics, where the first metatarsal bone is longer than it should be. This causes the joint to jam and bone spur forms on the top of the metatarsal head. Bunions on top of the joint also form because of trauma to the joints. Spraining the joint causes it to hyperextend and also causes a bone spur to form on top of the metatarsal head. This is commonly seen in injuries such as turf toe. Once the joint is jammed, every step causes a microtrauma. This causes the bone spur to grow larger. It can also make the joint become stiff. This is a condition called Hallux limitus or Hallux rigidus. Hallux limitus is a condition where there's limited motion of the great toe joint. It can lead to pain in the joint. Often, it's associated with a bone spur on top of the first metatarsal bone. This bone spur serves as a doorstop and prevents the great toe from moving further. This persistent jamming of the toe against the spur can erode the joint and lead to Hallux rigidus, which occurs when the great toe joint is bone on bone and barely moves. When the toe does move, it's very painful. It makes exercise painful and makes it almost impossible to wear a high heel shoe. Both conditions can be treated conservatively. This usually involves the use of a custom orthotic. The orthotic fools the foot into thinking there's more motion available than there really is. An orthotic can prevent the condition from progressing and also offer pain relief. There are times, however, when the only way to restore motion is to remove the bone spur. This is accomplished with a procedure called a chylectomy. A chylectomy removes the spur on top of the metatarsal bone. The head of the bone is remodeled to ensure that the great toe moves fluidly on the metatarsal bone. In Hallux limitus conditions, this is the preferred procedure. It's important to note that the joint needs to be in good shape for this procedure to be a success. In cases of Hallux rigidus, where the joint is not in good condition, it's essential to not only remove the bone spur, but also develop a working joint space. In these cases, I usually work with an implant that's placed on the head of the metatarsal bone. It serves as artificial cartilage to allow the great toe to move through a range of motion. When necessary, both of these procedures provide excellent results and restores full motion to the great toe joint. Thanks for watching this video series all about bone spurs of the foot. Please take a moment to like, comment, and share on social media. Make sure to hit subscribe so you won't miss another video. I also wrote a book all about bone spurs of the feet. You can get it for free at www.bonespurbook.com. The link is in the description. If you've noticed that you've developed a painful bump on top of your great toe joint, and it's becoming more painful to walk, run, or exercise, contact us for an immediate appointment. That link is also in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.